Host this week at the Dell Storage Forum. This is theCUBE. And we've been covering the Dell Storage Forum the last 3 days. This is day three for us. This is the second year theCUBE has been at the Dell Storage Forum. We've been witnessing the transformation of Dell, really on two vectors. One, of course, is the aggressive incorporation of intellectual property in storage through acquisitions. And the second major vector that we're hearing about today is really the integration between server and storage and networking, what we've been talking about as converged infrastructure. And we're here with Ben Tao, who's the Director of Worldwide Product Marketing for Virtualization and Private Cloud at Dell / Converged Infrastructure. Ben, welcome to theCUBE.
Great, thank you very much, Dave. Appreciate it.
So Stu, there is definitely a symbiotic relationship between converged infrastructure and cloud, isn't there?
Yeah, absolutely, and virtualization is kind of the driver for all of this. We talked about kind of the ripple effect of server virtualization having an impact on networking and storage, and we've seen a lot from Dell as to kind of pulling all the pieces together. They've made a lot of acquisitions. We had Dario on earlier this week talking about how the networking component come in, and what Ben has is the vSTART product, and if people aren't familiar with it, this is Dell's offering that kind of puts together, integrates, and makes, a sellable option that has the server, the storage, and the networking put together. So Ben, I'm wondering if you could just tell us the update on the news there. And the other thing, we break it into two parts, is there's converged and then there's integrated. So we saw the converged Equalogic array in the Blade chassis. Yep. So what's the differentiation, and can you talk a little bit about the portfolio
sure.
there?
Sure, so let me start out with the vSTART family. Yeah. So. This week we announced the vSTART 1000, but let me talk about the vSTART family overall. So to your description, vSTART is about pre-engineered, pre-integrated infrastructure. So it includes all the necessary components across server storage networking to deliver the customer pre-built virtualization infrastructure. One of the key things that customers want when they purchase is a vSTART is a fast implementation time. They're more interested in using virtual infrastructure. They don't want to spend the time of designing it, architecting it, ordering it, getting it in, receiving it, testing it, and actually building it before they actually start using it. So fast time to value is one of the key attributes of the vSTART family. It also gives them a very standardized block of virtualization versus if they order virtualization on their own every 2 to 3 years or every 2 to 3 quarters, they may get very different variations in the architecture. This gives them a very standardized architecture that they can base their entire virtualization infrastructure upon.
Ben, so just for clarification, we're talking virtual infrastructure, so do I have to run a hypervisor on this configuration?
Yeah, the vSTART 1000 or vSTART family in general is targeted for customers who want to run a 100% virtualized environment. They can certainly couple it with non-virtualized servers side by side, but the vSTART solution is 100% virtualized.
And my understanding, you have two flavors today. You've got the VMware and the Microsoft
correct.
Hyper-V.
Yep, correct. We support those two hypervisors specifically. So with the vSTART 1000, it's a little bit differentiated than the previous versions of vSTART in that the vSTART 50, the 100, and 200 were designed for smaller environments and were designed for customers who just wanted simple virtual infrastructure. They were rack-based servers, they used Equalogic storage because it's very easy to use. With the vSTART 1000, we're actually targeting a customer who really is looking for an application platform or private cloud platform. They're not just looking for simple virtualization infrastructure. So it's based on our latest generation of Blades, it uses our Compellent storage, specifically the Fibre Channel version of our Compellent storage, and it also integrates one of our more recent acquisitions in that it uses Force 10 networking for the TopRx switch as well.
Okay, great. So if we look, right, the previous generations of vSTART, it was rack servers, Equalogic storage, and the Power Connect on the networking.
Correct.
So now you've got kind of bigger environments
and
some of the newer pieces put
yes.
in there.
And it's also designed for customers, again, who want to deploy private cloud infrastructure. So for instance, it falls within Microsoft's Private Cloud Fast Track Validation Program. And that's a program that Microsoft has that works with OEMs such as Dell to ensure that, for instance, in this case, System Center 12 works really well with this infrastructure, this converged infrastructure. So when you combine System Center 2012 with vSTART 1000, in essence, you're getting pre-built private cloud infrastructure.
Yeah, so you actually did a dual launch with the vSTART 1000 this week. Actually talked to Scott Lowe, who wrote an article about the Equalogic Blade Array. He's at Microsoft Tech in Orlando, and he said he saw the vSTART 1000 and expect us to cover that a little bit more.
Yeah. So to your second question, the difference between convergence integration, we leverage integration as a way to drive differentiated convergence. So if you think about the second announcement, major announcement that we had this week around the Converged Blade Data Center, it's an example of using a common platform, in this case Dell's M1000E chassis, our standard 10U blade chassis, and doing a ton of integration between the active elements of the data center, server storage, networking, to form a converged infrastructure solution. And so we're leveraging the fact that Dell has the first and only quarter height server within a blade chassis, and we're using that particular blade server in our solution to maximize the number of nodes within this single chassis. We're leveraging the new Force 10 MXL switch as a switching device within the chassis. We're choosing that because it has 10 gig, 40 gig capabilities. It has outstanding performance from an east-west traffic standpoint, so all the virtual machines and all the storage that they're talking to has very high performance. In addition, it supports DCB, data center bridging, so it allows us to unify the both LAN and SAN traffic into a single network. And then finally, the last piece that we are missing as far as being able to integrate this into this overall solution is the new Equalogic Blade Array, so from a storage standpoint. So for customers who truly could put their entire data center within a 10U chassis, because maybe they only have around 100 virtual machines or 200 virtual machines, you literally could get your entire data center in this single 10U chassis with three cables.
Yeah, extremely simple. And that does have some scalability. The Equalogic can scale outside of the array, just
absolutely.
Like an external Equalogic could before.
Yeah, absolutely.
So Ben, I tweeted out earlier this week that converged infrastructure has become the ante in a high stakes game of data center infrastructure, and everybody's on the bandwagon. My question to you, and maybe Stu could chime in as well, is how much of what's going on here with the converged infrastructure is invention versus packaging innovation, and what does that mean for the competitive landscape? In other words, can startups participate? Is there an opportunity for them to fill white space? And where is the invention versus the packaging innovation?
Yeah. So when I think about the sources of value from an infrastructure convergence standpoint, I think there's sort of two main ones that Dell's exploiting. So the first one is what I would call form factor or hardware convergence, and that is true innovation. And in that, there's a lot of engineering work that is necessary to actually integrate all this stuff together and put it in a predefined package like that blade chassis that I talked about earlier. Mm-hmm. Back to your question of who can participate in this, it's probably not relevant for a single startup, but the people who can best bring value from a hardware innovation standpoint are end-to-end IT providers like Dell. Because by definition, it's server storage networking. If you only own a couple pieces of that, you can certainly drive innovation, say, around servers and networking, but if you don't own the storage piece, you can't have that third leg and drive innovation around what you could do, for instance, in a blade chassis. And so because Dell owns all three of those pieces, we can make all the tough calls and trade-offs between server storage and networking from a design standpoint and come up with an optimized solution for customers and not force customers to make those trade-offs on their own.
The other thing we talk about a lot over the last year or so here in theCUBE is this IT labor problem. And mm-hmm. what we mean by that is if you look at servers and storage and the associated spending, more than half goes to people and the processes around them. So, and our premise is that that investment is really constricting innovation at the buy side,
absolutely.
The practitioner base. And people always talk about, we talk about the 70-30 mix, 70%. Yep. The investment goes to maintenance, 30% goes to growing the business. Are we starting to move the needle, and do you have any proof points that you can share just in terms of attacking that problem?
Yeah, absolutely. So virtualization has created a huge amount of benefits for customers, specifically around capital expenditures, but to your point, it's actually created a ton of problems, primarily in the operational space. So you've sort of moved those dollars around, saved money on the hardware, but now I've created actually operational challenges and increased operational expense. And so if you look at going back to innovation within the converged infrastructure space, vSTART represents another type of innovation in that I'm innovating the consumption model of virtual infrastructure. I'm collapsing all the steps that are necessary to actually build out virtual infrastructure. I touched on them before, designing, architecting, procuring, actually receiving that all, testing, assembling, and so forth. We're collapsing, we're consolidating, we're converging that consumption model so customers can then spend their time actually using virtualization versus spending all their time actually maintaining virtualization. I think the industry absolutely has helped move that dial from that 70-30 to down to more palatable levels. Dell 4 years ago was probably north of 90-10. Mm-hmm. We were clearly not best in class. And through innovations around virtualization, innovations in improving processes, innovations around leveraging some of our own tools, we've actually gone below 50%.
You're talking about internally.
Internally,
Dell IT.
So, and that's innovation we've brought to the market as well. Mm-hmm. So we're proof that you absolutely can do it, right? We're below 50%, as I mentioned, and we're leveraging that IP and best practices in how we work with our customers.
So Ben, that's a great point about the kind of the consumption. We definitely see convergence as that time to market,
yep,
and deployment. The other real challenge is when it's ongoing, automation and orchestration.
Yep.
For a virtual environment, how much of this is, VMware vCenter, Microsoft, Center, or, Dell's orchestration layer? Can you talk a little bit about your software story?
Yeah, so in our current approach is focusing on leveraging the virtual consoles that our customers spend most of their time in. So to your point, it's VMware vCenter if you're a VMware customer, it's the Microsoft tool set if you're a Microsoft customer. And so our approach is what I would call an integrated management approach, lets you manage your underlying hardware infrastructure directly from those virtual consoles that you use today. So it's not another console you have to go to, it's another yet another console you have to integrate with the broader systems management tools that you have in place already.
Okay, what about the Dell VIS orchestration tools?
Yep.
Can you speak a little bit what those are and where we are today?
Yeah, sure. So you mentioned cloud versus converged infrastructure. Hmm. When I think about a private cloud infrastructure holistically, there's that hardware layer, which we generally call converged infrastructure, and then typically you layer on top automation software, primarily to provide self-service, provide some chargeback, but there's also the management of the actual workloads or the VMs throughout their entire life cycle. Because it's not a matter of just deploying virtual machines, you actually have to manage them through their life cycle, and at some point, you have to kill off that virtual machine once that project is done. And so that's what the VIS portfolio is designed to do. It's designed to help customers manage the virtual machines on top of that converged infrastructure, help manage it through that entire life cycle in a very efficient, automated way.
Great, so the other place, when you talk about making an environment comfortable for virtual machines, not all virtual machines are created equal. What's Dell done to kind of understand workloads? Do you have templates? Do you have, how many different workloads do you expect vStart to go into?
Yeah, great. So, great question. So to your point, vStart is basically just virtualization infrastructure. What Dell is doing is we're actually building what we call application recipes. So for instance, we have an application recipe for SharePoint that helps a customer understand best practices, how to deploy a SharePoint workload on top of that converged infrastructure solution that vStart represents. And we expect to have additional application recipes, initially mostly focused on the Microsoft application suite, but we'll expand from there.
So recipe is documentation, correct?
Yep.
So I wanted to ask you about that. So what's changing and evolving in the lab environment to support converged infrastructure? So, dial back, 10, 20 years, it was the IBM Red Book, and that resulted in documentation, a white paper, essentially.
Yep.
And there's a lot of talk about sort of reference architectures and then embedding some of that intelligence into the actual product. Is that achievable? Is that a pipe dream? And what is Dell doing in that regard?
Yeah, so we think the application recipe is the right level of value today, because the challenge with convergence in general is convergence absolutely is a trade-off, right? You absolutely are giving some things up to gain other things. And so with regards to tightly integrating those workloads directly into the infrastructure, we think at this point that's maybe a bridge too far from a trade-off standpoint for customers. And so we think customers still want these application recipes that provide best practices, because it does give them some level of flexibility. Like just with any other reference architecture or recipe, allows you some latitude to go left or go right. You don't have to follow the recipe exactly.
So let's talk about those trade-offs. So the value, obviously, integration, faster deployment, you're reducing your risk, it's pre-integrated, it's simpler. What's the drawback?
Yeah, so for vStart, one of the ways we get the very fast time to value is actually a fairly fixed configuration, right? That's the thing that allows us to actually be able to deploy vStarts very quickly. So if you want to, tweak a particular setting within a server, if I don't like that switch, I want this switch, if I want potentially a different type of storage technology, right, those aren't necessarily degrees of freedom within the vStarts. We have degrees of freedom within the vStart family, so if you want Fiber Channel storage, we have the vStart 1000. If you want iSCSI storage, we have the smaller vStarts. But there are sort of limited degrees of freedom within the actual componentry. Because again, we've designed this with best practices in mind. In a sense, we've commoditized virtual infrastructure. Customers, for the most part, don't build their own server. Right. For those customers who've adopted virtualization, they understand that that virtual infrastructure can be commoditized and standardized, and they can buy it in those standardized blocks, and ideally there's less need to tweak the blocks.
But, okay, so but some customers do want to. Now, how about this value in integration?
Yep.
I've said to customers, look, you should expect to pay a premium. Now, customers don't always necessarily pay a premium for converged infrastructure. What's Dell's philosophy there. Are you charging a premium for that integration, or are you trying to gain footprint, essentially,
yeah.
and
yeah.
compete on,
yeah.
on price?
Yeah, one of the benefits of the VSTART solution is it's actually available at a fixed price. Right, we actually have a defined fixed price that actually also includes the enterprise deployment services, which is it's not a special contract that you have. We actually engineered into the actual offering. So it's a fixed price. If you actually went to Dell.com and assembled it yourself based on the list price, it's lower than the actual list price that you can get at Dell.com. And so that's one of the things we've done with VSTART is we want to give customers a fixed price. So take it or leave it, walk away, make it simple. We think it's a good value price based on the value we're delivering. And so that's the approach we've taken with VSTART.
Yeah, so that's a premium, right, that people pay for that integration, correct?
Well, it's a discount relative to the list price on Dell.com, depending
but
on...
It has services packages in as part
yeah,
of
so
it.
Yeah, but the point is in the total cost of ownership, it's going to be less. And that's your
yes,
value proposition.
Yes, exactly,
but
absolutely.
From a CapEx standpoint, you're going to pay a little bit more than you would if you just... bought bespoke pieces and put together services on your
you
own.
You may or may not, it yeah. depends.
Well, you should, is my point, right? I mean, this is value.
Yeah,
there.
No, so yes.
And I'm always leery when
yeah.
people bomb pricing
yep.
and say, okay,
yep.
there's no, because
yep.
I think that's, yep. I think a lot of people are head faking and saying, all right, we're going to
yeah.
basically lock them in
yeah.
and jack up
yeah,
the
no,
price.
The way we did the fixed
Exadata
the,
way we down
did
the road.
The way we did the fixed pricing, we absolutely do it with a comprehension. There's a TCO benefit to a customer. Right, so if a customer doesn't value that sort of thing and are looking at initial purchase price, right, that's not that value equation may not work for them. But absolutely, we think we've priced it such that it still gives a very, very good TCO.
Yeah.
Okay. So first question I have for you is systems integrators used to do this work to kind mm-hmm. of put together the solution.
Mm-hmm.
How's VSTART integrate with the channel?
Yeah, absolutely. So a lot of our channel partners are pretty interested in VSTART. I've been selling it because to some extent, the work that I described that we're taking away from the IT administrator or internal IT staffs, to be honest, that's low value work for the channel as well. They don't want to necessarily be selling rack and stack and simple enterprise deployment services. They rather, for instance, be selling you virtualization consulting services to help you migrate some of your physical environment to a virtualized environment or size virtual machines, or even the more advanced value-add resellers want to do application work. They actually want to help you deploy that new application, either new application or upgrade from the previous application.
VDI is another one.
VDI, a new platform for Oracle or SAP. That's really the value-add services that the majority of the channel partners really want to engage on versus just simple rack and stack. So there's a value proposition for channel partners as well.
Great. The other thing, can you give us any indication as to, you know, how many VSTARTs are there out in the field and, you know,
yeah.
what and what gross margins
the,
are.
Yeah. what we expect from the,
and what's our future looking forecast?
Yeah, what, you know, so the hell is being added, the Blade server.
Hang on, let me check. I have that right here. Let me check. No, you know what? I forgot to bring that today. But more seriously, one of the, it was interesting. I was talking to one of the analysts here, industry analysts here at Dell Storage Forum, and they said, you know, we'd like to start tracking converged infrastructure sales and we want to have projections. And
I know who that is.
We sort of laughed and we said, good luck. Because back to one of my earlier points, convergence and converged infrastructure, there's no really well-defined metric. So for instance, some people offer just reference architectures. How do you count the value and the sale of a reference architecture? So to answer your question, VSTART is not only a fixed offering, it's an actual instantiation. There's a reference architecture behind VSTART that our sales teams, and more importantly, our customers absolutely leverage when they're buying converged infrastructure offerings for virtualization from us. So bottom line, it's hard to quantify what the actual impact is because we get great leverage from those architectures.
So, my final question is, when you look at upgrade cycles, it seems to be one of the toughest things. If you talk kind of reference architecture versus buying it all,
yep.
my server, my network, and my storage don't
yep.
go together.
Yep.
What's your experience been so far, and how are you overcoming that?
Yeah, so you're right. So back to the definition of what's converged infrastructure, is it just server networking, or is it inclusive of storage? You know, in our mind, to have that well-balanced system, we think it's really critical to have storage to, again, eliminate a lot of the challenges for customers. But you're right, there's a lot of customers who have established storage environments that they run as a silo, and they're going to prefer to buy in a much more piece part manner. So for those customers who really want that balanced system and have that mentality of buying things in a very modular fashion, VSTART's a great fit. For those who choose to treat storage as a separate consolidated silo, you know, we have other offerings for them.
Great.
Excellent.
And what do you think about the Patriots this year, Ben, as a final note?
You know, I think their offense is going to be definitely a little better. The defense, we're all very hopeful. But, you know, ultimately they have to demonstrate on the field.
You saw they signed Gronkowski for a long-term deal.
Absolutely. Hopefully Wes will be back. And even
Wes was cool about it.
Yeah.
Wes was like, hey, I'm really happy. I think they're, true team player.
Yeah, so they're managing their salary cap very well.
So ESPN has not taken over yet, but...
All right, Ben, thanks very much. It was a great segment. Really appreciate you bringing the perspectives on Dell's convergence strategy. This is theCUBE, and I have to say we couldn't be here without the generous support of Dell. And so thank you for having us here. Legal Seafood is our other sponsor. So go to Legal, go to legal.seafood.com. No, shop.legalseafood.com. Father's Day's coming up. So it's got ship all over the world, actually all over the country. So so check that out. But thank you very much. Keep it right there. We'll be right back live from Boston. This is Dell Storage Forum. This is theCUBE. Keep it right there.